If you have ever been working on bigger projects where you've printed more than one part at a time, you probably already encountered the problem that one of the parts got loose and ruined the whole print. Today, I'll show you how there is finally the possibility to cancel individual parts of a print. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. Most of you have already encountered the problem that you were working on a multi-part project, printed a couple of parts at once, and shortly before the job finished, one of the parts came loose of the print bed and ruined the whole print. You have either the possibility to still hope for the best, try to somehow fix the loose part in place, or kill the 3D print and start again from zero. In my normal job, I work with pretty expensive powder bed fusion machines, where a lost job can cost you hundreds or even thousands of dollars, so deactivating a part that is about to ruin your job is a common practice. I have been looking for such a feature on FDM machines for ages, but as far as I know, nobody has implemented something like that so far, until now. A couple of days ago, a plugin was released for Octoprint that lets you deactivate individual parts of your print job. Octoprint is a 3D printer interface that usually runs on a Raspberry Pi, which lets you monitor your prints remotely and many other things. In addition, it can be extended with plugins for even more functionality. If now a part of my print job fails, I deactivate it, finish the rest of the print, and just reprint the failed part. The new plugin that makes this possible is called Cancel Object, and it does exactly this. It's really easy to install by using the integrated plugin manager and searching for cancel. After a restart, the Cancel Objects plugin will be ready to go. I have been using it for a week now and already was able to find a couple of bugs which the developer was able to fix. Now it's at a state where I think it's well usable, even though it's still in an early development state. The reason why I still post this video is that I think this is one of the features future 3D printers need to have and it hasn't been addressed so far. So please give it a try, spread the word, report the bugs, help improve it with your ideas, and if you are a programmer, help out in the development. The way this plugin works is pretty simple. Before you run a job, it analyzes the G-code file for Marcos, where the individual parts start, and puts all of the parts in a list. When you later cancel a part, it will then skip the lines from a part marker until the start of the next part. And here comes the first current drawback, because only Simplify 3D is so far able to produce these part markers, and this also requires you to create individual processes for each part. To my knowledge, this isn't so far possible in any other slicer, but if you like this idea, then share this with the developers from Cura, Slick3R and all of the others, so also these free tools are able to be used with the plugin. Cancel Object will add an indicator bar at the top of Octoprint showing you the current object that is printed. In your settings, you can define additional things like which commands will be ignored, for example layer changes. As I said, the plugin is still under development and there are still a couple of things that need to be sorted out, like not unintentionally skipping layer changes or any other significant G-code. Also, I would really like to see a graphical representation of the parts for the cancelling process, which would not be too hard to set up since by analyzing the G-code, you could figure out the bounding boxes for each part. With the 32-bit controllers and touchscreens that become more common in 3D printers, I could also see this being implemented directly in the machines themselves. Some big thanks go to Paul Poxdallas, the developer of this plugin, who is sharing this great piece of code with the community. What's your opinion on cancelling individual objects of a print? Have you also been looking for something like this, or do you think that this just makes things more complicated? Please share your thoughts on this in the comments and let me know if you'd like to see this as a common feature.
I hope you also share the euphoria I see in this actually small feature. I really think that this is something which could make 3D printing more reliable and accessible in the future. Please share this video, hit the like button and try out that plugin. If you don't use Octoprint yet on your 3D printer, take a look at the description for the necessary accessories. Also, consider supporting me on Patreon and subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen and until next time!